From Learfield on the Vermont Sports Network, welcome to the Kevin Sneddon Coaches Show, presented by Milton Catt. Get equipped and get to work. Now, here's Michael Lehr.
Hey everybody, happy Thursday. Welcome to the Catamount Coaches Show. It's brought to you by Milton Catt. Get equipped and get to work. Located on Catt Lane in Richmond. I'm Michael Lehr, alongside who's usually Kevin Sneddon, but Coach Sneddon is in Canada recruiting right now, so we're joined by assistant coach for the Catamounts, Jeff Hill. So thanks for making your Coach's Show debut with us, Coach.
Yeah, excited to be here.
So we always have you for the post-game interviews, and we're always talking, you know, really quick, hard-hitting questions, as you were saying, about the game that was just played. But it's kind of a good opportunity for us to meet you a little bit more. We're going to talk to Bryce Misley later in the show, and then we'll talk a little bit about where the season is right now and this long break coming up. So for starters, you graduated from UVM and went from being a Catt to a Catamount coach. Can you kind of talk us through that whole trip to get back here to UVM?
Yeah, I can go through the whole coaching career, so to speak. So graduated here in 2008. So I played for Coach Sneddon all 4 years. I was part of his first recruiting class. So his second full season with UVM was my first year. Played a year of awful minor pro hockey, bounced around a little bit. I was in a few different cities, and then started my coaching career. And I had the opportunity to work with actually one of my former coaches at UVM, Damien Julian. He's the head coach at St. Michael's College now. Ended up calling Damien to congratulate him on his new job at Rice Memorial High School down the road here, and called to congratulate him. He was starting a prep program at the high school, and he was like, glad you called. I was actually just going to call you. I need some help. Wondering if you wanted to coach, and you were my first choice, and see if you wanted to get into coaching. And I was like, actually, yeah, sure, I'll do it. We did that for 3 years together. Started the program from scratch. We had, I think, like 9 guys our first year, and then built it up to like 16, 17, 18 guys. We won like 35 games. It was, it was big time. So, and it's still going. Program's still going. Dennis Vickers is kind of took the helm after we both left at the same time, and he's done a great job. One of our last guys that Damien and I had there is a goalie at Robert Morris University right now. Francis Marat, he's doing pretty well. He got invited to a couple NHL development camps. He was like Rookie of the Year in Atlantic Hockey. So kind of cool thing to have in a startup program. So
yeah, starting to kind of build up that that legacy of saying, well, now we got this guy here and this guy there.
Exactly. Yeah. And so from there, Damien left to go to St. Mike's, and then I left to go to Culver Military Academy in Indiana. Took over there, worked with actually another fellow Catamount, Ryan Miller. He graduated here in 2003. So that's how I ended up out there. Worked with him for a year, and then he went to UMass, and he worked with Joey Gasparini, another former Catamount, and one of my other former coaches, John Micheletto, over there. So kind of a Catamount.
Yeah, small little, Catamount world, right?
Yeah, exactly. So worked with him for a year over there, and then kind of took over for him, and learned a ton over there. It was an awesome, awesome place. And then my wife and I moved back here. She got placed in a residency, a dental residency, at UVM. So left, the cornfields of Indiana and moved back to Vermont. So that's how I ended up back here. So I did, volunteer my first year, volunteer assistant, like goalie coach pretty much. And then, did hockey ops for 2 years, and now here I am in this position.
And what's your role right now with the group?
I do a lot of different things right now. Still doing some of the ops jobs. Ryan Callahan, our volunteer assistant, he's helped me out a ton with that. And we have a new intern this year, Eric Elins. He does a ton of video stuff for us.
It's his first radio shout out, actually.
Yeah,
right,
nice.
There.
Eric,
that's huge.
Big
for
E.
Eric.
Big
yeah.
E is killing it. He's he teaches me some things sometimes about the Exos video stuff. So he's awesome. And so, you know, two new additions have been been really good and really helpful. So yeah, for the time being, for this year, kind of still doing the ops responsibilities, and then, you know, next year we'll get somebody to fill that role, hopefully. So do all that stuff. And then, from a hockey perspective, recruiting is one of the top things. And then, still work with the goalies, work with the forwards, a lot of the skill stuff that we do. And
so I want to get to the goalie thing later in the show too, but first with the recruiting thing. So when I talk to Coach Sneddon, he's obviously most focused on this year's team, right? And winning tomorrow, or at least just getting better tomorrow. How does the whole recruiting spectrum work with all four coaches kind of working together and also kind of going on separate trips and having separate roles as well?
Yeah. Like you said, I think one of the things transitioning from last year to this year is we really wanted to focus on our guys, and still be out there in recruiting. We have to, and that's the name of the game, to be honest. But we wanted to be around here, and we didn't want to miss games. We didn't want to miss weeks of practice. We wanted to be a little bit more strategic with our recruiting efforts, and really focus on our guys and get better. How that works is, you know, like Coach Sneddon, he's, you know, we don't have practice this week, so it's a great opportunity for him to go see some of our committed guys. Those are the things that he's going to do. KP and I will do a lot more of the trying to find guys, right? And then we'll say, hey, you know, Coach Sneddon, you need to go see this guy or what have you. But
that's actually interesting. I'm learning as this conversation is going on. All right, well, we'll be back with Bryce Misley coming up on Chat with the Cats. This is the Catamount Coaches Show, brought to you by Milton Cat. Get equipped and get to work, located on Cat Lane in Richmond. It's Catamount Hockey from Lehr Field.
Life is filled with uncertainties. Your career, your health, your family situation, they're all subject to change. So how can you plan for your future when you don't know what it'll hold? Hi, I'm Steve Gentile, a financial advisor right here at Morgan Stanley's Colchester office. I'll work with you to create a wealth plan and manage your investments through all of the changes. To get started, give me a call at 652-6007 and start planning your future today. Morgan Stanley Smith Barney, LLC, member SIPC. The Lehr Field Directors' Cup, the highly recognized mark of distinction in college athletics across all divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow your favorite team's pursuit for excellence in this prestigious annual award through thedirectorscup.com, USA Today, or at L Directors Cup on Twitter or Facebook. Lehr Field Directors' Cup, the crowning achievement in college athletics since 1993.
Citizen Cider, founded in 2010 on a hunch and some good old-fashioned hard work, has quickly become a leading player in the craft cider arena. Citizen Cider strives to look at the bigger picture and focuses on being involved in every aspect of their supply chain, sourcing all fruit directly from local farmers and pressing the juice to create a true craft cider, never from concentrate. Come see us on Pine Street in Burlington. Our tasting room is open every day, serving a full menu and delicious local ciders on tap.
When it comes to floors, windows, and doors, you want the best in high-quality service and selection. You could roll the dice with one of the big box stores, but why leave anything to chance? The professionals at Able Paint, Glass, and Flooring have sold and installed miles of flooring and thousands of doors and windows in Vermont homes and businesses. Count on Able for expert advice, free estimates, and top-notch service from technicians who care. That's Able Paint, Glass, and Flooring. Pine Street, Burlington, ablevt.com.
We're here to talk about Monument Farms Dairy. A lot has changed since we started this family-owned business back in 1930. But one thing that hasn't changed is the quality of products at Monument Farms. We produce and grow our own crops, raise and milk our own cows, and process and package all our own products. No growth hormones and no preservatives. Just delicious, great-tasting milk. Folks come from all over to try it. Local, fresh, healthy, landmark quality from the heart of Vermont. That's Monument Farms Dairy.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Touch again, my holder.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Hey, short on time, shop online.
That wasn't that hard, was it?
Come to Handy Toyota St. Albans, where we treat people great and our deals won't be cheap.
Short on time, shop online
at HandyCars.com.
Brickliner's Custom Masonry and Chimney Services knows that safety comes first. but striving to offer professional service, taking better care of their customers, and going above and beyond the call of duty with every job comes in at a close second. Call Brickliners Custom Masonry and Chimney Services, 872-0123. That's 872-0123. Brickliners, the ones to trust when safety is a must. Call 872-0123.
Right now at Milton Cat, get 0% for 60 months on new cat equipment. Because we know growing your business isn't just one thing, it's a million little things. And we're ready to help. With expert advice, flexible financing, and industry-leading equipment, you can get the job done, day after day. Get 0% for 60 months on new equipment. Visit a Milton Cat location. Call 888-702-0073 or go to MiltonCat.com. Terms and conditions apply.
Hey everybody, this is Chat with the Cats, presented by Milton Cat. Get equipped and get to work. It's located on Cat Lane in Richmond. We're here with sophomore forward Bryce Misley. Bryce, thanks for making a return to Chat with the Cats for us.
Yeah, no problem.
So first, just to get us started, you want to give everybody kind of an introduction to you, where you're from, where you played hockey before you got here?
I'm from Canada. I grew up in Calgary for most of my life, and then I moved to Ottawa for a bit, and then I'm living in Toronto right now. I played hockey growing up in Calgary and in the minor hockey league, and then junior hockey in Oakville, which is kind of near Toronto, and then came here.
So with all three Canada cities, who's your hockey team?
Calgary Flames. I consider that my hometown. So
okay, that's good. So what was kind of the first thing you noticed about coming to college hockey versus playing in Canada, and now you're in the States playing in the NCAA?
First thing I noticed is, at least college wise, with everyone being older and stronger, there's not a lot of room out there compared to where I played in junior. So you got to make decisions quicker and you got to be stronger. So I'm working on getting stronger right now because I think that's the most important part.
And how's the year going for you so far with everything?
I think off ice I've been getting stronger and on ice I've been improving. Year hasn't really gone how I wanted to go so far, but it's still early, so still pushing.
All right, we're here with Chat with the Cats with sophomore forward Bryce Misley. Now we've got the fun questions. Well, first, so any NHL player that you idolized as a kid or who you model your game after?
Yeah, my favorite player growing up has always been Daniel Briere. He's retired now, but I loved, I'm not a small guy, but I loved for him being a small guy, his perseverance and his heart in the game and how he always stepped up in big moments. I know he was like one of the best playoff players ever, so I really looked up to him. But I always style my game after Jonathan Toews, kind of the two-way playmaking centerman. I think that's a good guy to kind of model your game after.
Yeah, it's a pretty good combination if you put those two together too, right? If you could have dinner with a non-hockey famous person, who would it be?
Non-hockey, I'd probably go maybe Conor McGregor.
Nice.
I don't know. Kind of seems like it'd be a fun time.
I think he's an all right personality,
I guess.
I feel like it would be fun to see if he is actually the way he portrays himself, right?
Yeah.
It'd be fun to see if he just kind of fits the personality or not. Okay, what is your lucky number?
My lucky number is number 18.
So you cut it in half for your jersey?
Yeah, I cut it in half this year. Still mad at O'Donnell for taking that, but...
A little bit of seniority that for him. So maybe in 2 years, you can slide in there for your senior year. Okay, if you won the lottery, what's the first thing you would do with the money?
First thing I would do is probably buy my parents and my brother a house.
One house, or your brother gets a separate house?
My brother gets a second place. Maybe smaller, maybe like an apartment for my brother, but a house for my parents.
All right.
Because they've put so much into what I've done. And then I would probably donate a little bit of it. And then invest the rest. Maybe
be smart with it.
Have a little bit of pocket money. But
I mean, you won the lottery, you might as well, right? Yeah. All right. So if you had a secret mission assigned to you by Matt Bain, he came into the locker room and needed a secret mission, and you got to pick one teammate to go with you, who would you pick?
I think I would pick Matthew Beck.
All right. Beck gets picked for so many different answers to these questions. Like, he's in everybody's band. He's everybody's partner for this stuff. Why are you going with Beck?
He's a gritty guy and he gets the job done. And he has the heart of a lion. So I feel like if you want a guy on your team, it's that guy.
All right. I like that. If you could have a band with three teammates, who is your band?
Three teammates. I would go lead singer, Dallas Como. He's got the voice of an angel. On the drums, I'd put Connor O'Neill. I think he kind of looks like a drummer.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Did he shave the mustache?
Yeah, he did shave, so he'd have to grow that back.
Yeah, just for the band.
Yeah, just for the band.
For the posters.
And then I'd go with my producer and guitarist, Brian Kelly. I think he's probably the most musical guy on a team.
Yep, everyone says that one for sure, which makes sense. I mean, you might as well actually be logical and pick a music
I think
he'll
bring the group together.
Okay, what is your favorite holiday?
My favorite holiday is Christmas. I think Christmas time just makes you feel warm and getting home. I know I'm not home a lot, so when I get home to see my parents and family, it's nice. And also, I like winter and skating on the outdoor rinks and everything. So everything about Christmas kind of appeals to me.
Are you going to get to go home over this this break coming up?
Yeah, I'll get to go home for about 12 days, which is
nice. Nice. That's great. Is it a flight home?
I'm gonna fly home, but I'm only in Toronto now, so it's not too far. But I'm still gonna fly. Yeah.
All right. Well, thanks a lot, Bryce, and good luck the rest of the way. Yeah,
thank you.
This was Chat with the Cats with Bryce Misley, brought to you by Milton Cat. Get equipped and get to work. It's located on Cat Lane in Richmond. Back after this, it's Catamount Hockey from Learfield.
Right now at Milton Cat, get 0% for 60 months on new cat equipment. Because we know growing your business isn't just one thing. It's a million little things. And we're ready to help. With expert advice, flexible financing, and industry-leading equipment, you can get the job done. Day after day. Get 0% for 60 months on new equipment. Visit a Milton Cat location. Call 888-702-0073 or go to MiltonCat.com. Terms and conditions apply.
You want to be confident that your investments are working for you. Wouldn't it be nice to get guidance to help make that happen? Hi, I'm Steve Gentile, a financial advisor right here in Morgan Stanley's Colchester office, and I could help you create a wealth plan and help manage your investments, even help you work towards a comfortable retirement. Give me a call to start your financial plan at 652-6007. Morgan Stanley Smith Barney, LLC, member SIPC.
Guild Tavern, Williston Road, South Burlington. The Farmhouse Group's Tavern and Steakhouse featuring wood-grilled burgers, Vermont steaks, seafood, and more. Recipient of the Wine Spectator Award of Excellence and offering Vermont beers and signature craft cocktails. Join us at the bar for dinner and drinks before the game. Serving dinner nightly, located just minutes from UVM Athletic Facilities. Find out more at guildtavern.com.
I'm Jeff Bushy, sales manager at the Best Western Plus, Windjammer Inn, Windjammer Restaurant, and Upper Deck Pub. I've been personally working with UVM Athletics for over 20 years, and I've seen some amazing games at the Gut. We wish Kevin Sneddon and the UVM Athletics the best this season. We're also proud to be a Victory Club sponsor for UVM Athletics and look forward to the continuing success of this program. And if you're at the game or plan to attend one in the future, I personally invite you to join us at the Upper Deck Pub. It's a great place to meet before or after the game. And keep us in mind when you have guests coming in from out of town. Go Cats, go!
There's just something about Vermont. It's more than green mountains and maple syrup. It's about the people. It's what makes us strong. No other company has symbolized Vermont's strength and independence more than Vermont Mutual. The only place to purchase Vermont Mutual policies is through local independent insurance agents. Vermont Mutual is the oldest insurance company in our state and also one of the highest rated in the nation. For your home, auto, and business insurance, visit Vermont Mutual online to find a local agent near you.
Hi, this is Matt
and John Erickson
from Vermont Paint Company.
As your local family-owned Benjamin Moore dealer, we are proud to partner with UVM Athletics.
On staff, we have a UVM alum, a UVM junior, and parents of current UVM students. So when you purchase Benjamin Moore from Vermont Paint, you really are supporting local families.
Serving Catamount Country for more than 79 years, Vermont Paint is conveniently located in Williston and Burlington and online at vtpaint.com.
Go Cats, go!
The Learfield Director's Cup, the highly recognized mark of distinction in college athletics across all divisions, both men's and women's sports. Follow your favorite team's pursuit for excellence in this prestigious annual award through thedirectorscup.com, USA Today, or at L Director's Cup on Twitter or Facebook. Learfield Director's Cup, the crowning achievement in college athletics since 1993.
We're here to talk about Monument Farms Dairy. A lot has changed since we started this family-owned business back in 1930. But one thing that hasn't changed is the quality of products at Monument Farms. We produce and grow our own crops, raise and milk our own cows, and process and package all our own products. No growth hormones and no preservatives. Just delicious, great-tasting milk. Folks come from all over to try it. Local, fresh, healthy, landmark quality from the heart of Vermont. That's Monument Farms Dairy.
Welcome back, everybody. This is the Catamount Coaches Show, brought to you by Milton Cat. Get equipped and get to work, located on Cat Lane in Richmond. Here still with assistant coach for the Catamounts, Jeff Hill. And now we're coming off last weekend. I wasn't actually there, so I didn't get to see the games, yeah. But I listened to Morris Sheridan call them. Split the series with Colorado College way out west. What were the coaching staff's immediate takeaways? And also just that last game, why is it so big to get a win to end the first half of the season?
Yeah, big takeaway for us was... I think the story of the year, our resilience. Friday wasn't our best showing. And I don't know if it was the travel, the altitude, who knows. They outplayed us. They kind of took it to us on Friday. And it was a frustrating game. But we went back to the drawing board and we... you know, we challenged the guys to kind of come up with some things to, hey, what do we need to do to improve? And they took a little bit of ownership, and that was a pretty good step in the right direction in terms of our leadership and our maturity as a group. They certainly showed that on night two. We made some adjustments systems wise, but the big difference was the effort that they brought. Obviously, they had a ton of shots on us. We don't want to give up those shots, but I thought we did a really, really a much better job off the rush and identifying guys coming back into the zone and kind of limited their grade A opportunities. That being said, Steph Lekas, again, I'm sure you're sick and tired of hearing how good Steph Lekas has been. But I think Coach said it after the game. He's playing an All-American right now, and he's... I said it after the game, I'd put him up against anybody in our league, in the country. He's been a stud for us. So he was the difference in the game, but collectively guys played much, much better.
So I agree that kind of fans might eventually get sick of hearing Steph Lekas is sensational. That's the word Coach Sneddon seems to always use for him. As a goalie and as the goalie coach, what makes him different? Why is he making the saves that other goalies just aren't making?
You know, his approach to the game is he approaches the game like a pro. His demeanor is very calm, is even keel. He doesn't get too high or too low. He is a very good self-evaluator. He knows when he messes up. He knows when he does things right. He is a student of the game in his position. Like, he wants to, immediately after games, we watch video.
I've seen that on the bus when he'll even come up during right after the game and want to watch it with you.
Right after, yeah. He just wants to, know what he's doing wrong, what he's doing right, and how he can make adjustments. And that's the approach he takes. And then on the ice, the physical attributes are, he kind of separates himself from other goalies because of his compete level. He never gives up on a puck. I wish sometimes he would give up on pucks in practice, because I feel like he's just going to wear himself out, but he never gives up. And that's tough to teach, right? Like, that's something that he has innately. And, the thing, you know, a lot of goalies have that, sure. But, the way he thinks the game, I think is what separates him. He's a, you know, whatever, 5'10", 5'11". He says he's 6 feet. I don't know if he is.
Hey, I'll say he's 6 feet if the media guy says that.
So maybe gotta give he's him 6 feet. Inch. So regardless, he's not huge, right? So his save selections and the way he makes saves is all based on his attributes, right? Like, whatever it takes for him to make a save. See a lot of goalies just default to dropping to their knees to make saves. Like, he makes saves against Colorado College standing up and things like that. Just reads the play so well and reads the shots so well. He just plays everything to his advantage and just knows his game. And I think that's why he's so successful, because he knows what he is and what he needs to do.
So this is something I feel like nobody really asks about Steph Lekas, and you would know better than anybody. Where can he get better? What are you guys working on every day in practice to take a guy that his head coach will say he's an All-American and make sure he improves?
You know, there's little things in the games that we kind of focus on, say his hand placement or, you know, things like that on a weekly basis. Just like, hey, he comes to me and says, hey, I feel like my hands were down and back and trailing a little bit this week. Can you take a look at it and keep an eye on it? So like there's a little tweaks here and there, like week by week, that, you know, like I wasn't good with my hands this week. Let's focus on that. I don't know if he has a weakness per se, thing that, I think he would agree, that we'd like to work on the most is playing the puck, both the, you know, actually physically playing the puck and his puck handling and passing and things like that, but also the decision making and understanding that he has a lot more time to make plays when he has it and help his defenseman out a little bit more. That's something we've kind of been focusing on all year. Like that's a consistent thing that you know, we need to improve there. That's the one thing, I think.
I was excited to ask you that question because I figured you'd have a unique perspective on it. So just one more question to wrap it up. Guys have a pretty good break right now, maybe pulling from your player experience here and also as a coach. What does this 20 days off do for the guys? A lot of them get to go home and they come back and it's a fresh second half of the season to get better.
For sure. Yeah. It's much needed. It's a grind. Like these guys, it's a full-time job that they have, right? As student athletes, they're in exams right now. And so the guys are, they're tired, you know, and it's a much needed break mentally, physically. It's good to get away from each other for a little while too, right?
Yeah.
And, you know, they're with each other from 6 weeks in the summer through September. We're on the ice, you know, a few times a week. And then once October hits, it's they're together 24/7, and it's good to get a break from all of it, just to rest your body and all that stuff, because it is taxing. Like we play a pretty tough schedule, and we've had a weird schedule this year with our first half, like, you know, playing on you know, some Sundays and, you know, things like
exhibition games
on a Thursday, yeah. And yeah, just things like that. So it's been a little weird and a little taxing on them. So just that break is going to be huge for them.
All right, coach. Well, thanks for the time today. It was a good coach's show debut.
Yeah. Thanks, Mike. Appreciate it.
Same place, same time next week, 6:30 on News Talk 620 WVMT. This was the Catamount Coaches Show, brought to you by Milton Cat. Get equipped and get to work, located on Cat Lane in Richmond. You're listening to Catamount Hockey from Learfield.
Landowners, get ready for red-hot deals during Mahindra's Winter Savings Event. Let your Mahindra dealer help you save thousands on the toughest tractors and utility vehicles on Earth, like up to $7,400 in cash back and savings, only from the world's number one selling tractor, Mahindra.
Visit CCR Sales and Service in Essex Junction and Swanton. To learn more about Mahindra, the world's number one selling tractor, visit ccrsalesvt.com. Official tractor of Vermont Athletics.
Offer with approved credit. See dealer for details. Program restrictions may apply.
Hey, hockey fans, it's Matt from Zero Gravity Craft Brewery. There's one thing I've learned through my love of playing and watching sports. It's that win or lose, I always enjoy myself. But we all know that winning is a whole lot more fun than losing. I think the same can be said about beer. Drinking beer is usually fun, but drinking really good beer is a whole lot more fun. Just like winning. You follow? Give Zero Gravity a try, and let's keep winning together. Cheers from Zero Gravity. And remember, please enjoy responsibly. Go Cats.
Have you been thinking about electric car charging stations for your place of business? Cummings Electric can show you how to get up to 80% off the total cost of purchasing and installing an electric car charging station with a grant from the state of Vermont. Cummings Electric is your local authorized charge point dealer in Vermont. And now is the time to give Glenn a call and learn more about grant money currently available. Call Cummings Electric today at 802-658-1292 to learn more.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Touch again, my holder.
Short on time, shop online.
Short on time, shop online.
Hey, short on time, shop online.
That wasn't that hard, was it?
Come to Handy Toyota San Alvin, where we treat people great and our deals won't be cheap.
Short on time, shop online
at HandyCars.com.
From
from Learfield on the Vermont Sports Network. This has been the Kevin Sneddon Coaches Show, presented by Milton Cat. Get equipped and get to work. The preceding has been a Learfield presentation on the Vermont Sports Network.